Albano. I own Trubia Home Inspections in White Plains, New York.
I've been a home inspector for about 5 years now. I've been in the construction field for over 20 years.
So why is it important for the buyer to actually be there for the inspection?
That's a good question. A lot of the times buyers ask if they even have to be present. They're not sure if they have to be. There's only so much you could put in the report. So much of this is conversational, where you have to just meet with them and point out, you know, how the house works, how it functions, things to keep an eye on that wouldn't necessarily make the report as a flaw or defect, but just something they should know as a homeowner rather than just someone buying the house.
So, well, when people do go to an inspection, they should focus on, obviously on everything as a whole, but focus on the major items in the house. Make sure the inspector is looking at the electrical panel. He's taking the cover off the panel. He's looking at the heating system, the cooling system. He's looking for termites with destroying insects, any moisture issues, the roofing system, you name it. The major stuff, they should really be there for that.
What are the big ticket items that would make a person walk away from a home?
Well, I guess it changes. Yeah, I guess it changes house to house and person to person. You know, sometimes, you know, as realtors, you know that you're working with clients that are at the top of their budget. Mm-hmm. So right away, if there's no negotiation room for the house and they're at the top of their budget and I say, hey, the roof and boiler are both there, you know, they're both at the end of their life, you're going to need to replace one of them or both of them within the next year or two, you know, that right there is kind of a deal killer, you know. So we do look for those major expenses, the big expensive replacements of something that is required, like a roof or a boiler. But you know, I guess there could be many little problems that could scare away a buyer also, but I always...
Now, what about for condos and co-ops? How do you feel about that?
I'm big on that, yeah, because a lot of times people say, ah, what are you going to look at? There's nothing to look at. Well, I mean, explain something. There's a lot to look at in there. I've owned a co-op, so I know a lot about them as well. Yeah, if it's 800 square feet, 1,000 square feet, it's not huge, but you have a sub-panel that's in there.
Yeah.
You got to take that panel cover off. You got to look inside there. Like, I've come across a bunch of them that were Federal Pacific. Federal Pacific is a huge no-no in the electrical field. Those breakers will heat up, they can melt, and they can catch fire. Rodents. Leaks, the windows, the outlets. I've come across a lot of no-nos in co-ops, and I've saved people a lot of money.
Yeah.
So what is the process? They hire you, you go out, and you check all the different components, and then you give them a report or?
Yeah. I mean, usually I like to speak with the clients over the phone, just discuss the different services we're offering. You know, some of the agreements that we're going to have and the standards of practice that we work within. You know, we find a good time that it is for the realtor, them and myself, to meet at the house so that we have at least 2 to 3 hours to do the full home inspection. And then, yeah, the inspection, once it's completed, you know, they'll have a good verbal idea of how the house checked out, but within 48 hours we'll have a digital report over to them with digital pictures, and that way they really get a sense of page by page how the house checked out.
So why should buyers not just walk away if the home is not perfect?
Nothing's perfect. That's number one. Whether it's a brand new house or the house is 100 years old, fully renovated, nothing is perfect. There's always going to be something. You have to look at what's really wrong with the house. Is it a little improvement item or is it a major, major issue? Is the house tilting to one side? Is the boiler system, heating system, the electrical system, if everything is, I don't use this word in the field, but if everything is shot, that's a big deal. My clients, I have a lot of like first-time home buyers, people moving in from the city, they come up here and, you know, they love to see a piece of chip paint on the wall and like, what is this? The house, why is it? I'm like, calm down, you're gonna get through this. It's nothing big, you know, and the main thing is walking them through it, you know, feeling them out and seeing what their expectations are for the home that they're buying.
This area, you usually deal with a lot of older homes. If the home's older, it's fine. It's just we want to make sure that home's been maintained and things have been updated in time and that you're just not dealing with problem after problem with all the different systems and components. You know, if we're having issues with electrical, plumbing, heating, cooling, everything, that's where it's going to be a tough home to live in and expect, you know, you have to expect some issues there.
Right. Now you know.